Good day, beautiful people. This is a P2B versus Tinubu court proceeding update. As you know, INEC have closed their defense and Bonda Ahmed Tinubu has opened his defense. So today, Tinubu tendered an evidence. Well, I will not call it evidence. He tendered a document he called evidence that P2B is not a member of the Labour Party. So I have this comment from one of my fans. It says, Tinubu tendered evidence of Obi not being a member of Labour Party. I am scared. So, I'm making this video also replying the comment from this Godwin. The truth is that, number one, P2B is a full member, a bona fide member of the Labour Party. End of the case. But before I explain further, it's important for me to show you how Labour Party primary, presidential primary was conducted last year, how P2B won Labour Party presidential primary, and tell me, if somebody who is not a member of the Labour Party could emerge during the primary or can even contest for a party's primary when you are not a member of the party. Take a look at this video while we come back to analyze how useless the evidence could be. Stay with me.
For the purpose of this election and for us to move forward our party and to move forward this nation, I will step down for Peter Obi.
Now, at this moment, you are going to watch, during the primary election of the Labour Party, how Pat Otome and three other persons stepped down for P2B and how P2B won this primary election and how he was declared the flag bearer of the Labour Party. And this is the same man Tinubu brought a paper from Arabambi and Apapa saying that he is not a member of the Labour Party. Continue watching this video to the end.
This afternoon,
yeah, no problem, thank you.
on behalf of the national leadership of the party, presents the flag of the party to the winner of today's presidential prize. Comrade Peter Obi.
It is an opportunity to contribute in rebuilding Nigeria. We need to rebuild here. We need to give the future generation a hope in this country. A country that is so endured with human and natural resources that have been mismanaged over the years needs a turnaround. And that is the work we just started today. My involvement is about building the future of the youth. The youth of this country have a lot of talent and a lot of energy. All they need is government properly articulated support targeted towards them. And I know what to do to unleash that energy and that productivity so our country can become productive. A country of 200 million people today is not producing what a country of 20 million people are producing. So I can and I have what it takes to unleash that productivity.
I am glad you are still watching this video. You know, I have to bring up old videos to explain what I want to say. So if there is anybody telling you that Tinubu bringing a document he called evidence that Peter Obi is not a member of the Labour Party, that document is dead on arrival. So do not let anybody to make you think otherwise that, oh, Tinubu is presenting evidence that Peter Obi is not a member of the Labour Party. If you are not a member of the Labour Party, there is no way, no how you can participate in the primary of the party. So everybody in the Labour Party, they are not useless for somebody who has not been a member. Even though you are a day member, you must be a member. In fact, let me just tell you, for you to buy from that you want to, you know, vie for a position in a particular party, you must be a member. So even though Peter Obi was not a member before, by the virtue of buying from, you must feel form of membership. So that evidence must be trashed. So that is it. So do not think that that thing is called evidence. It's just something. After all, they are in the law court. You know, they are defending evidence that the Labour Party, PDP, has brought. So they must find something to say. They must find something to argue with. You don't expect them to come and say, no, we don't have anything to defend. So they have something to defend. And they have started defending. So let's see how the outcome of the court proceeding is going to be. But I'm so optimistic that Tinubu and INEC will never survive this court case. Within few weeks from now, probably next month, we are going to see to the end of this case and know where we are standing. Above all, we love our country, Nigeria. We want Nigeria to be a better country. Thank you so much for having time to listen to this video.